Okay, this is Sunday the 27th, and I was going through some of the links that I found on dutchsinse's latest video, and I wanted to read this. Yesterday on March 27th, radiation levels of more than 100,000 times the accepted limit were recorded at Unit 2. Further to that, levels of radioactive iodine-131 recorded 330 meters offshore reached 1,850 times the standard. Both high readings indicate that the fuel rods inside one or more reactors is damaged and that the radioactive materials are leaking into the water. Okay, we already know that. High levels of radiation have already been detected in units 1 and 2, 10 times the limit. So TEPCO decided to inspect Unit 2 in addition. TEPCO had originally announced levels of radiation for iodine-134 at 10 million times the standard, but admitted later that it had been mistaken. However, the readings taken from the surface of the spilt water in Unit 2 were unchanged and showed readings of 1,000 millisieverts per hour, the needle on the diosimeter going off the scale. Readings for iodine-131 taken 330 meters offshore from the drain at the Fukushima Daiichi showed readings of 1,850 times the standard on March 26th. Readings the day before were 1,250 times over the limit. So work to cool the reactors has slowed because of the recent developments and high levels of radiation recorded. They are currently trying to extract the leaked water from the basements of the adjoined rooms containing the turbines for the reactors in units 1 through 4. Highest readings as of March 27th were iodine-131, half-life of 8 days, 74,000 becquerels. Cesium-134, half-life 2 years, 12,000 becquerels. Cesium-137, 12,000 becquerels. Now, obviously, we can't read the graph in Japanese. One brief note. Let's see. Iodine-131, the value recorded was 5.0. The acceptable standard is 4E. The amount over the acceptable limit is 1,250 times. Cesium-137, the amount over the acceptable limit is 79.6 times. Then it goes into trying to figure out, you know, the calculating, scientific calculations and all that. But I just did want to share because it is interesting to me that that scare of 10 million times the standard for iodine-134, you know, they retracted that statement. But here he's saying that no, it really is still that high, but that is not what they're, it's not what they're calculating in the air. That is in the water. So, you know, as I delve into some of these places a little bit more, I will try to share whatever I'm reading so we can get little bits and pieces of truth out there. Thanks, Dutch, for all the links. I'm being proactive, and I'm not waiting to just see where the, you know, where this is all going to go. I'm searching out information, which is very difficult, as everybody knows, because nobody really wants to tell us truthfully what's going on. Alrighty, God bless.